Well, Mr. Chairman, ladies and gentlemen, I was scheduled to be here 40 minutes ago, so I bring some speech note prepared for Minister Ratajczak. But that is really a pleasure to be here among the world-leading experts in open access and this matter. So the digital age creates new conditions and possibilities based on open access to scientific content. ICT enables free and immediate online access to knowledge in the form of e.g. papers and reports, research data, source codes. As has been proven, open access brings many benefits to countries, both scientific, economic, social, and political ones. Among the most important scientific benefits, let me mention facilitating national and international research cooperation, avoiding research duplication, transparency and anti-plagiarism, faster and more effective verification of research fundings, greater opportunities for multiple reuse of research results, assistance in conducting interdisciplinary research, and support for management and evaluation. The openness of science also has an effect on our daily behavior. The less expensive electronics, the more companies use the principle of free in their business model, and the popularity of the free dares to make claims for its steady expansion. Growing movement of open science is more than just a fad, more than just one of possible options for the development of science together with commercialization, more than just flagship postulate to the younger generation under the so-called open culture. One of the basic characteristics of scientific research is its public nature, sharing the findings so that can be repeated and checked, and finally recognized by others. Without critical assessment of new findings by other competent investigators, without repetition of the experiments, without their reproducibility, without the consent of research community generally, the discovery will not enter the canon of knowledge. Disclosure of new findings is an integral component of the research ethos. Keeping them secret threatens the progress of knowledge. For example, medieval science did not support open communication. Modern science began with the free and open communication. In this sense, the movement of open science is the application of the basic principles of research in the new digital era. But the open science movement is creating new opportunities and discovering new chances for other basic characteristics of science. The open science movement has created and developed new and wide possibilities of transfer unimaginable before the digital age. In this effort to keep abreast for recent developments in the world, the Minister of Science and Higher Education prepares action plan for open science in our country, in Poland. We already have a pretty well-developed ICT infrastructure, which we can use for the purpose of open science. We will now try to change the approach of researchers to publish the results of their research. Today's conference is therefore held at a very good time. I'm convinced that keynote sessions, presentations, and discussions will help us to prepare a better plan of action. Participation in the conference of representatives of both government and academia will raise awareness of open access among researchers and contribute to better regulations mentioned by Rector before. So I wish you a good conference. Let me leave you at 11 because I have to left for my other duties. But our representatives are here in the room and many people, so we are watching and keeping to learn a bit from your international experience. Thank you very much.